Twitter at King of the Dot, at Organic Hip Hop, co-host.
Yeah, Gully TK, go to KOTDstore.com, get all the gear, something for your girl. You already know what it is, let's go.
All the way from Philadelphia, rapper to my right, introduce yourself.
I said, it's your boy Uno Lavoz, 215, Deep Thoughts. Shout out to all my fans, shout out to Nog the Boss, shout out to my fans that be like, yo, you don't do what you usually do, well, fuck it. I might do it today, so word up. I got y'all.
Cheers! Former King of the Dot champion, rapper to my left, introduce yourself.
Hurts my heart when he says that. poRICH! Big Demon, yo, bitch! The Beer Baron. Well, I tell you, but then I have to kill you. I came here for two things. To kill this bitch and take his drinks. 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 Get it, let's go. Whippy is a city, bitch. Hey, lighten up, eh? Let's start laughing, eh, guys?
Uno Lavoz won the coin toss. It is not 2 minutes. I'm fucking up all over the place. It is 2 minutes on poRICH. Let's go.
Let's go.
Quiet.
You're sweeter than lots of licorice schnapps. This fucking chocolate cinnamon drop is off his meds. Give him a shot. He's walking dead into a plot that's built as big as a crib where he squats, which is pretty small since he lives in a box. This obnoxious twat's never getting his props. Some people still think he's spitting it hot. Yeah, right. And I'm the King of the Dots. I told Organic I was taking a break after World Domination. He offered me Uno. I said, why not? I'm on vacation. Let me drink. Please, let me drink. Boy, you barely a thought, no concentration. I'll be scaling buildings, running down walls like condensation. Up in your neighbor's house like the wrong location. Just to hit him from a distance like long relations. Ugly faggot. Connotation. The night they made you, Pop had a condom waiting, but never got to put it on before your mama raped him. Pussy, you ovulating. This confrontation is combo breaking. A silverback from the Congo nation, boiling noodles, break bonds with Satan, a freedom fighter with the John Connor cadence, and a Jeff Hardy bomb, swanton bomb you're facing. I told Organic I need to start making it clear. I won't battle anymore unless I'm paid to be here. He said, fine. Took me to the bar and I drank a free beer. I looked up, gazed in the mirror, saw your face in the rear. Got me thinking how to go from front runners to face in the rear. It's strange and it's weird. You're basically here so I can get my fucking name in the clear. I mean, going from Dizaster to you was a weird reversal. I went from a fucking Mace song to a beer commercial. And you're just a quick Vic. They didn't even put this faggot on the map yet. Your mom was a rain dancer and your dad held the secrets of the Aztecs. Want to hear a little moron, these moron guys? His dad's face was Zordon size and his mom's pussy looks like Sauron's eye. Hey, hey Cuddy, but if she's a hoe, then I'll give her a go. Pass it to me. You naturally have the physique of a vaginal crease. That was molested by a Catholic priest in the back of his Jeep. I knew if you told your dad, he'd kick your ass for a week. How y'all gonna think this cat's in my league? Y'all have to agree. The whack rapper disease made contact with his genes. Got crushed by Kid Twist. Now you're here battling me, getting killed by the better half of the team. I'm with this. Hey, hey, let me drink. Please, let me drink. I'm with his mom. She be loving my stroke. I'm trying to cover her face with a couple of ropes. She started laughing with my cum in her throat. So I bent her over and fucked up the butt of the joke. Now make him laugh, faggot.
I will.
Let's go.
Let's go, round one. It's on Uno Lavoz.
Stop boring everybody. Stop boring everybody. Neither your mom queef sounds like Organic hosting. I know what the fair. Chill. I said, I know what the fans are thinking. They're like, poRICH goes from Dizaster to Uno. That's lame. Don't laugh at that. Why?
when you're a drunk piece of shit who utters preschool verses. Your ex-girlfriend's a known slut. You had the most losses in Canada. You had more haters than fans. As a fact, it's for certain. So of course we will battle Rich. We're exactly the same person.
Wow.
I said, you was born rich, but you have a poor attitude. And that's something we see. And Organic noticed that and told Dizaster to come over because a real champ is something they need. So they told Dizaster to give him $1,000 for the chain, plus give him his additional fee. So Dizaster came to KOTD for two reasons, but it fits in one sentence: to get rich off this league. I said, if you really want to go to the hands, my nigga, don't do it. Reinforced movements. You never been lucky. This game, my horse shoot it. Short fuses with pussy-ass niggas thinking they more human. I said, since you're an alcoholic, if you start to whine your face, I'm a corkscrew it. I said, you was happy when you beat Sketch Menace. You even rejoiced to it. I said, you barely make music, and when you do, arthritis. It hurts to hear your joints moving. You tell PH some Wu-Tang punchline like, I'll make you OD, B. That's how I know your wordplay was so useless. But he's an alcoholic. That just means blowing into a breathalyzer test is the only time something came out of your mouth that had a point to it. I said, but fuck that. I'd rather tell you something that I get your feelings hurt. Like how your mom wanna fuck, she came over to my house wearing that miniskirt. I had a tattoo on my dick that said, you're hired. She asked, the process really hurt. She said, why didn't you tat that? I said, bitch, cause you about to get this work. After I left that pussy open, never to be tight again. Completely demolished. I mean, I left that pussy so wide you can have a conversation inside. Hey, Rich, you mind me and you speaking in private? I said, fuck that, gum bars. I got a Chinese assault rifle, so if we'll rival friends across the street inside of bushes is where I'm hiding in. I be waiting for you to wake up to go inside your whip, so as soon as you put on the seatbelt and you try to split, the trigger is pulled and your mind gets hit, but from the side of it. And the impact hole was big enough so a tiny dime could fit, and the window was filled with brain fragments dripping off the side of it. Now remember, I said a Chinese gun, so if you don't get what I'm trying to hint is that you're an alcoholic, so it should be nothing for you to take all these shots of gin. I said, but fuck it, I'm keeping it cool and I'm here to remove this stupid little poser. You prove you was a bitch because against Dizaster you gave him a lot of space, but against other opponents, you usually choose to move it closer.
My bad.
I said, this is where it all stopped, where your role to hold the torch is over. I'm the Heath Ledger of this rap shit. Why I say that? Because you went from being a king to demoted to a joker. I said, with that metal in my hand, I'ma pop that shit. Your mom comes to your rescue, I'ma drop that bitch. You're winning streak, I'ma stop that quick. It's not gonna be a punchline.
Why is that?
Cause I forgot that shit.
Clown with your drunk ass style, let an alcoholic shine, sit your drunk ass down.
It's the same thing.
Thank you.
Rap to it, so poor bitch, let's go.
Hey, relax. Please, let me drink. Just let me drink, please. In a fist fight, your weak heart will break. Fuck up your whole crew. Won't even need to see my team charge your flank. But in a battle, having to listen to this retard spit more than 3 bars in length? Well, that's gonna take some retarded strength. But I feel bad. I mean, ain't it awful to think? As a kid, he was dropped on his head when it was still as soft as a froth in his drink. The staff at your beer store, especially friendly. They raised you from a baby the day your parents dropped you off with the rest of their empties. Your daddy was bad news pimping, but smart enough to keep his tattoos hidden, otherwise he'd lose his job at the fast food kitchen and someone had to buy the family Pabst Blue Ribbon. A bunch of y'all in one apartment, sleeping on a cheap couch. You could touch your mom when you put your feet out. You had a rough life, I'm so sure. People neglecting and beat you, whatever, that's so forced. You're a degenerate runaway, running with coke whores, pondering your demons, fighting your own wars, wandering the streets, sleeping on cold floors. Now you're homeless, and I bet you wish as a kid you would've went home more.
Now what about me? See, I work, making a living, but still help out at home. Yeah, I'm taping the trim and painting the ceiling. Do you ever question your parents' relationship building, get the occasional feeling they hated raising their children? See, now you live the loser life. How you thinking you were tight? PH, watch me do it right. I'll kill him with all drinks. Yeah, it'll take one Coors Light. So maybe it's time you start riding the wagon. Every battle you're lying and bragging, screaming and moving. It's a giant distraction to hide that he's rapping like a 9-year-old faggot. Now they've assigned a violent combatant designed to attack him. Gannick says a name on the phone. That's how he hires assassins. You think this is an Iron Man match? Talk about your Jimmy Pistol, get your entire hand slapped. And if I see him step up, bang that 57 on the side that has Heinz leaking ketchup. So please, I keep the infrared locked. Get an ambulance while Brendan Shanahan review a headshot. And we can battle. Hey, and we can battle on the block. Pick a spot up on the roof. You can choose your mama's stoop, and I'll squeeze the honest truth of this little pompous fruit, turn him into Jamba Juice. And y'all paid to see your favorites rep. Or he blends. When Rich is in the lineup, everyone else is number two, tapered back. Woo! I'll take a piss in his hoodie. If you picked him, you pussy. I'm Robert Picton, making victims of pussies. Your girl think I'm Prince Charming. It's heartening. A little smile and a drink are pretty disarming. Then it's back to Whitby for a little pig farm. And yeah, hey, let's just address this right now. After I battled Dizaster, I took off my shirt. What's hood? And yeah, that might have looked bad, but you know I look good. Woo! Yeah,
boy. Oh! Round two on the levels, let's go.
Let me drink, please.
Your mom pussy smells like bluefish. Or maybe even goldfish. Or maybe even, magical moose bitch. Yeah! I didn't say drinking is a problem. Hold on. Yeah, I only got 2 minutes. I didn't say drinking is a problem. Now that conclusion isn't clear. Look at Rich. When he's sober, he's a pussy, pathetic, coward. And when he's drunk, the motherfucker has no fear. People who say drinking is a problem don't realize the solution is in the beer. Shit, alcohol isn't addictive. That's what Rich said. Shit, he should know. He's been doing it for years. Sight, no. You never seen alcoholic shit, the real is here. The only reason he doesn't drink and drive is because he's scared he might hit a bump in the road while he's driving and spill his beer. I said, but fuck that. I'd rather grip a bat, break it over your spine, and leave you with a broken back. Lavos is gonna kill you. Now the third person just told you that. Or fucking, I'll get a knife, cut your face like this is the part where I'm supposed to act, draw a dick on you, and just leave all eyes, nose attached. Wait a minute. All eyes, nose attached? Fuck slowing it down. If you speed it up, it sounds exactly like all I know is that. Ho ho ho!
Source.
Oh ho ho! Chill. Oh ho ho! You know the famous quote from the guy who dig deep in your bitch and in her mouth, he left his fucking scrotum sack? I said you thought you was gonna win this battle, but what you thinking, rich? Dump your body in the trash can. They won't find you until you stinking, rich. You better kill me, rich. These people feel me, rich. Your ex-girlfriend left the sorest poker. Now that pussy is filthy rich. Oh. I said, but fuck with me, you can go to the top all the way to the bottom tier. Anything can happen when I take my beer. You might battle me after you lose to Bashir.
Anything can happen when I take my beer.
You might get beat by me and go away for a year.
Anything can happen when I take my beer.
Let's go, guys.
I said, you be sketching, PH. You got cocky and your chest was puffy. I said, then organic brought Dizaster over. See, the best was coming. You exceeded our expectations. It's like you released a part of you that was suppressed or something. I said, a lot of people thought you won that battle and the rest were funny. Yeah. You had wordplay, crazy delivery, very impressive punching. You had rhyme schemes. Every bar was on point, sharp enough that his flesh was cutting. But they still gave him the battle. It's like organic told you to bend over and accept your fucking. Because you were like a Hurricane Katrina survivor. Because thousands of people saw you beat a Dizaster, but it didn't matter because at the end you were still left with nothing. Oh. I said, so listen here, nitwit. Fuck around and get hit. Poor man status. I'm trying to get rich, hip toss your grandmother to the bitches walking with a slit disc. After this, I'm going back to selling chocolate milk, nigga, biscuit. After this, you're gonna be wondering why in life you're such a misfit. One of the reasons is because the Zoris fucked your chick and I fucked his chick. So shit, bitch, even my dick is more legendary than this dick. Drunk ass clown with your drunk ass style, let an alcoholic shine
to your drunk ass now.
Yeah.
Round three, poRICH, let's go.
Go.
He's garbage. I should strike him down. Why they invite this clown? They're thinking if you clash with Poe, people might just like your sound. He's Will Smith, a Philly kid waiting on the rich to turn his life around. See now I'm giving him pain. Ain't no Vicodin pills. He talking tough on Twitter, thinking about the hype he can build, but wasn't shit till I spoke to him like a bicycle wheel. Now I'm excited. Hey, now I'm excited for real. Even brought my passport, just in case the club wouldn't accept my license to kill. And he thinks he's tough, because it's easy to talk that way. And it might be evil to live backwards, but boy, it's hard to walk that way. Your whole style's pseudo. I asked my friend if she'd fuck Uno. Her reply, fuck, ew, no. And still he thinks he's a gift to the world. His name means one voice. Too bad it is a girl's. And they ain't realize that when they booked him. My voice got better bass and percussion, so I knew I would win. You had the breath control of a vegetable, but with your mind state, that's exceptional. They put a mental probe in his temporal lobe. Now every time he gets the flow, his head metronomes just to set the tone. And when you're this dumb, you can't have your mind read. How come before every rhyme this guy says, I said? Well, I said, he says, I said. You said, I said, I said. Your bitch diarrhea until her eyes red. But you be blinded by her beauty. You unwinding with the groupie. Wine and dining with that blue cheese scent that seemed to be coming from between the two knees. She got a fat ass, but between them huge cheeks is a doozy of a dookie. Dry clean wash. You're gonna need a couple tunas. Shut up. Now what sort of people come from Puerto Rico? The Puerto Chicos who got caught because they can't afford a speedboat. Immigration? Shut it. Immigration won't even let you get this work because you're illegal. Por favor, amigo. It's jokes over bars. Cool, I know who you are, so I'm past that. But that just proves the sad fact that all of your songs are laugh tracks. So you're in for a good old-fashioned Poe clasher. I'm coke, acid, you're so aspirin, you broke has-been. I stroll past him like go gadget, the chrome magnet, then pant off, Bo Jackson. I've been here since day one. I feel like an old man. I'm one battle away from retirement. The plaque, the watch with the gold bank. Feeling like a senior board member. Fuck this rookie. I'm old school, like Michael Landsberg on SportsCenter. So in conclusion, fuck Uno Lavoz. Muchos gracias for being such a stupid asshole and looking like chewed tobacco. Rich, bitch.
Grown man jokes. Something he gonna have to deal with. Cause no matter how many punchlines he spit, his mom about to be real pissed. Nigga, your mom's such a slut, she named you Richard just so she could call you Dick. She'd be wearing plastic headbands. And your grandma got no arms and she's an alcoholic. Bitch be doing keg stands. Now when you first got the chain, you gave the fans nothing but aches and pains. And you even gave these guys some stress. I mean, the people were literally vomiting and off of nausea off of this guy's success. I mean, fucking, you was the biggest headache that KOTD ever seen when they let that chain hang over on the side of your neck. See, it's funny how Organic was giving you all the shots, but he was, but his league was the one catching all the drunken side effects. Mm-hmm. I said, but fuck that, I'm on my gruesome shit. Tie your mom up, throw her ass up in a crawl space. Tell her I'm filming a reality show. It's called Assault Rape. I said, tie her up to a contraption that could be... Tie her up to a contraption that could be filmed in a movie Saw 8 and it's just a fucking machine teabagging her fucking long face until her fucking jaw breaks. And a lot of people want to talk about me and my ex-girlfriend. Fuck that shit. That ain't even a factor. I mean, she was just some chick that I boned, so that really don't matter. I mean, you fucking really did lose the Sketch Menace, and because of the fact PH choked, that win isn't even a factor, so if anything, you're more like my ex. Another Canadian bitch known for showing her ass and jerking a couple of rappers. Yeah. Sorry. Sorry. Fuck that! I said your mama freak. I'm just saying. My dick a toy. She loves playing. She want the nasty. I'm okaying. Bandana over my dick.
What's that?
Gang banging. I said, in other words, your mommy, she be saying hi. She see you, she's saying bye. When it comes to having sex, best believe she does oblige. In my room, she comes inside, and her legs, she's spreading wide. I finger fuck that bitch pussy into that bitch and screaming, ay! Ay! I said, oh, hold up. Hold up, before I fucking forget. Bro, your battle with Dizaster, the way it ended, had my eyes fucking squinting in pain. I mean, you had your shirt off in a room full of dudes. And that's simply just gay.
You know I look good.
I mean, that shit was like a... I mean, that shit was like a fucking Mardi Gras. Just without tits on display. I mean, that shit was like a Mardi Gras because Diz took off his top as soon as you gave him his chain. Mm. I said, but fuck it. I don't have to be armed with weapons. This is the end for you. But since you're known for being a pirate, this is your Armageddon. Time.
poRICH, Uno Lavoz, make some noise, y'all. Ayo, King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is. Grand Prix Semi Finals, Uno Lavoz, poRICH, Toronto, make some noise, y'all. Dope battle, judges came to a decision. The winner of the battle, poRICH.
Good, poRICH, about Uno Lavoz. I won. Good to him, man. Like, that was the fun shit I was saying. Like, this is the first battle I've done in like a year where there was nothing really on the line. It wasn't any big money or no titles or any win streak on the line or anything like that. I just had a good time, you know. It was dope. I had a great, you know, fight. Yeah, man, I had a good time. I can't stop professing that much, you know. It's nice to battle another dude who enjoys the art as much as you do, but also likes to have just as much fun with it as you could normally would have. You know, shout out to Uno. He killed it. You know, if I wasn't always on my straight face game, I probably would have laughed at everything he said. I'm sure when I watch it back, I will. But peace to Uno, peace to King of the Dot. Shout out to Organic. This was a personal favor to you, Organic. That's the last favor you get from me. Maybe I got a couple more up my sleeve. Either way, peace to King of the Dot, Aubrey Rex, PvP, fucking Philly D, everybody fucking hooking this up. King Fly, all y'all. King of the North, still at the end of the day. It's Poe, baby. Peace.
I said, it's your boy, Uno Lavoz, 215 Deep Thoughts. Just had a battle with poRICH. Shit was fucking crazy. I don't know, I really enjoyed it. It was like the most fun I've ever had in a battle. Really don't care for the decision. Whatever. It is what it is. I don't give a fuck. But yeah, shout outs to poRICH for like giving me that battle. And shout outs to King of the Dot and everyone else. And I'll be back soon. Word.
What's up, it's Tommy. We just saw poRICH and Uno Lavoz. I'm gonna make it nice and quick, be a dick about it, but round one, I gave to poRICH. Round two, I gave to Uno. And the third, poRICH definitely took that. And yeah, it is what it is. King of the Dot, I gotta judge the next battle. Peace.
Yeah.
What's up, King Fly? Make sure you check out KOTDstore.com. Grab all the merch. We just watched Uno Lavoz against poRICH. Uno automatically lost the first because he used a fucking get that work scheme. Anybody that uses that in any battle automatically will lose a round to me. Uno did take the second, and I kind of thought poRICH bodied the third, so I give it to poRICH in three. Peace.
Yo, what up? It's Q. 49ers, I fuck 40 miners, but let's go. I will tell you that poRICH, Uno's Lavoz was a very good battle, very close. A lot of judges were talking. I had it tied after one, I had it tied after two, and then I had poRICH winning by a point and a half in the third. Nameless's judging system of the 2.4. All I need is the 1 point judging system. That's my system, and my system is always right. You can get it here. poRICH, please.
What's up, everybody? Got Pang back. We watched another battle just now. Damn, now that shit, depending on how you feel. First round, I watched it. I'm thinking, you know, Rich opened out really well. Then Uno came out and he opened out just as well. That round was close to me. Like, it's close to call, but I'm going to go with Rich on that one. Second round, I felt was the pivotal round that someone could have made shit happen. Rich started off a little, Then Uno came in and kind of was the same way. They had some lines here and there, but no one really capitalized there. So, I mean, it was all about the third round at that point, and I felt poRICH just did what he did. He was ready for that. The scheme at the end just proved more that I liked what he was doing in this battle, and that's what got him the victory today.
Yo, what up? It's Jess Blaze, Keel Strip 416. We just watched the battle with Uno Lavoz versus poRICH. I gave the first round to poRICH, came off strong. Basically showed everybody why he is the ex-champion. He came really, really hard. Second round I gave to Uno Lavoz. I thought poRICH's bars were harder, but Uno Lavoz, he was fucking hella funny. Came with some funny, funny stuff. And then the third round, I gave it to poRICH because, I don't know, I just thought his bars were more strong. He was really getting at him. As a battler, he wasn't really, like, beating around the bush. He was being relevant about his bars and shit. And Uno Lavoz was funny, too, I mean, but he wasn't really getting at poRICH himself. But, yeah, no, I gave the battle to the ex-champ, poRICH. 416, Keel Strip, you already know, Jess Blaze.